Hello everyone, welcome back to Geek Disorder's web series over HTML5, CSS3, JavaScript, and jQuery. This is Lavik. I'll be walking you through this series. Today we're going to be going over measurements and how to use them and kind of like how they work. Alright, there are four different types of commonly used measurements. There's pixels, points, EMs, and percent. And out of those four, you can break them down into two categories, absolute and relative. And we're going to go over how each of these work. Alright, so I have a basic HTML5 document set up here. I set my titles to measurements. And I save this on my desktop as an HTML file. So down here in the body, we're going to start off looking at, let's start off with percent. And we're going to look at that based off of widths of some divs here. So I'm going to just create a div. Oops. Alright, and inside this div, I'm just going to put div 1. Alright, now I'm going to go ahead and close this and save this. I'm going to go up here and I'm going, for you to actually see this, we need to add some background color. And let's go ahead, and I'm going to use embedded CSS, so I'm going to put style, close that. Alright, now I'm going to put div here and open curly braces, close. And if the CSS part you really don't have to worry about right now, because all the stuff we're doing I'm going to be going over later. I'm just going to put this measurements in here so you can kind of understand how each one works. And so what I'm going to do is I'm going to give it a background color of blue. Alright. I go ahead and save that. I'm going to go ahead and run this. And there we go. Background color of blue. And this is div 1. If you notice, that goes all the way across. That div takes up the full width besides a little bit of white space over here on each side of my browser. So to change this, I'm going to put width and I'm going to say 50%. And if I go back up, save, and run, you notice that is 50%. Now, if I change the size of my browser, it changes with it. It's always 50%. All right. Now, if I was to take and put another div inside this current div, and I'm going to put div 2, and up here, we have div set at 50%, the background color is blue. So we need to actually, let's change that so it's so we don't have to do some use a class or anything like that. And I'm gonna put let's just put a paragraph. Paragraph is a block element. Alright, and up here I'm gonna set some CSS for the paragraph. And I'm just going to put the background color for right now. And I'm going to set that to yellow. And if I save and run, there we go. That's my paragraph. If you notice, we have a div here. And then we have a paragraph. The reason the div, if you looked at it here, the reason the div is up here and the paragraph's right here, remember the paragraph is a block element. And so since we have this text right here, it moved down a line and then it displayed. Okay. So let's go ahead and give that a background color. And you notice it is 100% the same as our current div. Now if we give this paragraph a width and we say 50% and I save that, and I run, now if you notice, you can see that it is inside this div because there's some blue background, and it is always going to be 50%, not of the width of my browser, because it's inside this div, so it's 50% of that width. Okay, our div 1 is 50% of my browser, div 2 is inside that div 1. So it's 50% of div 1's width. And that's how relative works. It's based off of what it's in. Absolute. If I was to use some absolute, we'll take a look at how this works. Let's use pixels here. And so if we go back up here, and I change my width here to, let's say, 350 pixels, and that's px. And I save this, and I run. Blue is now 350 pixels. If I move this, it does not change at all. You notice if I go all the way over, it gives me a little scroll bar. My absolute, width is absolute. It does not change. No matter how much I change the width of my browser window, it stays exactly the same. But if you notice, my div2 is 50% of that width. Now if I go down here and on my div2, I give it a width of, let's say, of 340 pixels. And then I launch this in Firefox. There we go. There's 10 pixels left that it still displays blue there. And yeah, it's not going to change size no matter what I do here. So see, the pixels, even though div2 is inside div1, the pixel is still the same size of a pixel outside the div in the browser anywhere in the browser window, no matter what element it's in. A pixel is a pixel on my monitor. It's absolute. It doesn't worry about the size of anything else. Okay. All right. So that's kind of how a good look at absolute and relative. And I hope that makes some sense to you there. And that was using percent and pixel for our width. Now we're going to turn and we're going to use point and EMs. And we're going to look at some fonts here. So let's go ahead. I'm going to go ahead and get rid of some of this here. Actually, yeah, I'm going to leave the background colors. Actually, let's just redo all of our CSS. All right. So down here, I'm going to go ahead and get rid of this too. Get rid of my divs. And we're just going to start fresh in the body here. Okay. So let's go ahead. And I'm going to add some stuff in the body here. I'm just going to put 1 EM in the body. There we go. Well, let's go ahead and up here. I'm going to run this right now. I'm going to save and run. And this is one. This is. Oops. I got it twice here. Alright, save and run. There we go. Alright, this is the default browser size, font size. I just wanted to show you that before I put 1EM in. And you're going to see it's not going to change. So I'm going to switch back over. And now I'm in here. I'm going to put body. And if I can get that right, there we go. And I'm going to put font size 1EM. And we'll save. We'll run this again in Firefox. 1EM in the body. If you look, these are exactly the same. You can't even tell, except that I got that one highlighted. See, they're exactly the same. So 1EM is equal to the browser's current font size. If the user changes the font size in the browser, your font is going to change with it. All right. And remember, EMs are relative. So they're relative to whatever the current font size they're in. Whatever element they're in, whatever the current font size is, it's going to be based off of whatever element that's in and so on, because they're going to change with it. So down here in my body, I'm going to move over and I'm going to do a paragraph here. All right. Now I'm in the body and I'm going to say, let's see. I'm going to put 2EM in. Alright, there we go. 2EM in the P. And down here, I'm going to create. Well, I'm going to go ahead and create a paragraph CSS code. And I'm going to put font Oops, font size equals 2 yam. And we'll go ahead and run this. Alright. Can't really tell, but this right here is double this. If you were to stack two of these on top of each other, you would get this right here. And there's probably a better way for me to display this for y'all. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to change the paragraph's basic nature, which I'm going to change it from a, as you know right now, it's a block element. I'm going to change it from a block element to a inline so our text is right side by side. So to do this, I'm just going to display. I'm going to put inline. I'm going to save. I'm going to run this again. And there we go. As you can see, this is twice the size as this right here. Alright, so that's 2 em. 2 em just means I doubled the size. Now I can put 1.5 em. That's 1.5. That's 1.5 times the size. So yeah, I can do point something. I can get as specific as I want, but right now I'm gonna keep it with 2 em. Alright, now inside this paragraph, let's clean this up so this looks a little bit. Alright, inside the paragraph here, I'm going to put a span. It's an inline element. And in the span, I'm going to put this is 1 em in the span. There we go. Now, right now, I haven't added any CSS. I'm gonna launch this in Firefox. If you notice, this is all the same size. Okay, the span is getting its font size from the paragraph. All right, now if I go down in here and I put span, and then I say font size 1 em. Okay. Now here's where you see the relative part of EMs. I put 1 EM. You might think that it's going to be equal to the body because they're the same size, right? Well, if I save, make sure I save this. If I save and run, you notice this is 1 EM in the body, but this is 1 EM in the span. It's getting the current size of the font. It looks back at the paragraph because that's the element it's in and sees the current size is 2 em. So when I put 1 em, that's what it's doing. It's 100% of 2 em. And that's the font size it displays. So if I change this 1, I'm going to put 2 em and save and run. You notice it's twice the size of this. So as you can see, relative. It's relative to the element it's in. If the element it's in has a 2 em size, it's going to be 2 times that. If it has a 3 em size, it's going to be 2 times 3. So, it's going to be double whatever it's in. It's not going to be double of, like, the browser's font size. It's going to be double of the font size of the element it is in. It's relative to that element. All right, so let's go ahead and look at some absolute here, and we're going to be using point. So if I go back up here and points, remember it's 1/72 of an inch. So if I put just one point, and I'm going to go ahead and change all these measurements to point. All right, I'm going to change the wording here. I'm just going to put body. Right here, I'm gonna put P. Right here, I'm gonna put span. All right, I'm gonna save this. I'm gonna run. We got 1, 2, and 2, and this is gonna be real small, very small, as you can see. So, yeah. So we gotta make this bigger. We gotta use more points. So I'm gonna put 100 here. I'll change this one to 100, and we'll change this one to 100. Save, and we're running Firefox again. There we go. That's 100 points. All right. Now, if you notice up here, if I go ahead and change that to 2, and this to 2, remember using the EMs, the relative. We'd start out with 100 points. Since I put 200 here, you might think it's going to be double that, and then I'll put 200 here, it might be double this. Well, that's not how absolute works. Absolute isn't based off of what you're in. Okay, so you can see these are the exact same size, and this is 100 points here because that's the body. It's our body font size, and if I use the same, if I just change this to, I'm just gonna put high, and right here we'll put high. So they're all the same word, the same wording, and you can see this a little bit better. There we go. That's 100 points. Well, I changed this to 200, so it's double that. And I put this as 200. It doesn't matter that it's in this paragraph. A point's a point, so they're the same size. If I go up here and I change this to 100, save, and run, it's going to be exactly equal to the body. Okay, because there's no relativeness here. It's all absolute. What you put in there is exactly what you get. All right. Well, that's kind of an overview of measurements. We're going to be using measurements more. You'll see different measurements for font sizes, margins, borders, padding, a bunch of different stuff. So you'll get to see how they're used, and you'll kind of there's some people like to use absolute, some people like to use relative. It's kind of up to you, and or more importantly, if you're looking for a job, it'll be up to the people you're working for. There's a big thing with using responsive web pages. If you go from a computer monitor to a smartphone, it's a totally different size of viewing, and so the web page, if you're using absolute, it's going to be the same size on both. You're going to have to scroll over on your smartphone, search around the web page and such. But if you use relative, that web page is going to go down to the smartphone. Especially if you between pixels and percents. So it's based off the viewing size. All right, well, this has been Lavik. If you have any questions or want to comment, let me know how I did. Our next video is going to be going over color. We're going to look at some of the different ways you can specify color and such. So, all right. Well, I hope y'all have a great day. And if y'all like our content, please like, subscribe, and comment. And we'll see y'all next time.